Our God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead, he's surely alive.
Hello, brothers and sisters, how are you? Well, we've reached another year to Resurrection Day 2021, the day that our Lord and Savior was raised from the dead. So, what does that mean? Well, Jesus was crucified on this past Friday, but he rose from the dead today on Sunday. He died for our sins. He was buried in a tomb. But yet, he got up from the dead and rose and resurrected so that we could live again from our dead bones and from our carnal, sinful ways. He has risen today, and now he sits on the right side of the throne of our Heavenly Father as our intercessor for you and me. So why do you weep? And why do you fret? Why do you have doubt? Just believe that the Son of God, the man of God, has risen. And he wants us to rise from our sinful and prideful ways, to have our shackles released and our bondage. He wants us to rise from the dead. And now that he has risen and left the Holy Spirit within us, we can live by the Spirit and not by the flesh. We can say no to our old sinful ways if we just pick up our cross and follow Jesus. God's not dead. He's surely alive because he's living on the inside, roaring like a mountain, like a lion. He's living on the inside and roaring like a lion. As we are now on fire for the Lord, we are now heirs of Christ. We are now part of the body of Christ. As he is the vine and we are the branches, we are now to go out and make disciples of many nations. We are his light to the world and salt to the earth. So let your little light shine, my brothers, and fret no more, and just believe that Jesus has risen from the dead, and now he lives within us so that we can rise with him. Amen. So let's engage in scripture today, shall we? To back up God's message about the crucifixion of Jesus and the resurrection for life for all of us. Amen? So reading from scripture today in the Bible, we're going to read from the book of Romans, Chapter 10, verse 9. Romans was written by the Apostle Paul. But before we engage in scripture, we always pray over God's word to ask for understanding, which God's words provides us with, the knowledge, the understanding, and the wisdom. So let's engage in scripture on God's word about his son, Jesus, the resurrected king. Amen. May we bow our heads and close our eyes in reverence in honor of the good Lord. And Father God, here we are once again, your servants. We come to you at the heel of the cross, looking up on this resurrected day for our Savior, our King, Jesus Christ, our Lord. We pray, Father, that you open up our minds to receive your word as we engage. As we become intimate with you, we ask, Father, that you allow it to reach our hearts, because we believe that every principle and precept, every statute and decree that you have breathed into the Bible is to be true. We can count on every word. We know that everything you say comes to pass and always comes to fruition. We just want to say, God, thank you for your word of truth that gives us everything we need. Because we know that man cannot live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. And Heavenly Father, we would ask that you allow your word to reach our feet so that we can practice what we preach, so that we can walk the walk and walk the talk, and to not be like the Pharisees nor the Sadducees, who spoke of you, but their hearts were far from you. For we know, Father, that it's not what goes into a man's belly that defiles him, but it's the word that comes out of his mouth. Because everything that is spoken from our mouths is spoken from our hearts. So we ask for cleansing, Father, to deliver us from our evil and wicked ways, now that your Son has risen. All for your glory and purpose. For us to have our salvation, so that we are not condemned to hell. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for your Son Jesus. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son. For whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And Father God, we have no doubt that everything that you have taught us, have given to us in the love letter of the Bible, we can stand on it as our foundation. Thank you for our Lord and Savior who has risen from the dead. And now dead bones arise so that we can live with you, Heavenly Father, and Jesus again. Thank you for this revolutionary change of transformation from within. We've changed the way we think. Now we ask the Holy Spirit to come within us, to renew a new spirit within us. Decrease us, Father, and increase the Holy Spirit within us. This we ask all in Jesus' name we pray, forever and a day. Amen, amen, and amen. All right, brethren, I hope you prayed along with us and asking God to give us the understanding and asking him to allow the Holy Spirit to now dwell within us. so that we can resurrect from the dead, so that we can be born again and live for Christ Jesus, the one that died for us and rose again. Let's engage in scripture, shall we? In the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 9, and it reads, "If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved." Brethren, you just have to decree and declare that Jesus has been raised from the dead by our Heavenly Father. You shall not doubt, but believe. No need to weep. No need to cry, because joy comes in the morning. Whenever you cry out to God in prayer, which is communion with the Father, which is a way that we draw nearer to God, he will draw nearer to you. Furthermore, God already knows what we need before we even ask. He is a provider, and he's always working on our behalf. He's always standing in the gap. He came down, lived with us, dwelt with us, walked with us, and taught us how to live in the land. Yes, he was crucified on a Friday, but thank God for today, on this Sunday, on this resurrection day that we celebrate, Easter Sunday, for the risen King. This was the will of God for our lives and for Jesus. This is what God has shown us through many signs and wonders and miracles. He's performed many, and he's not about to stop now. He is the same God yesterday that when our forefathers and foremothers roamed the earth. He is the same God today while we're living in our generation. And he'll be the same God tomorrow for our children, our grandchildren, and our great-grandchildren. He is the same God that provides righteousness, justice, and fairness. We serve an impartial God, a God that shows no favoritism. There is one law, and it's not the law of man. It's the grace of God for the sinner. So I would encourage you, I would implore you to rise, dead bones, rise, and come out of the darkness of that tomb that you lie in, and come into the light and be resurrected with Jesus Christ. This is the message. The Bible is summed up of one word, and that one word is love for the sinner that is broken and wretched, prideful, wayward. But there is the message of Jesus. And his message is what we teach and what we preach. He died for our sins, crucified, led to the slaughter like a sheep being led. Oh God, he was tormented. He was tortured. But thank God, he rose again to show the omnipotent power of God. Thank you, God. For your son is not dead. He has risen. He now sits on the right side of the throne of our Heavenly Father, as our intercessor, as our advocate, as our lawyer. He speaks on our behalf to God. No one gets to the Father but by Christ. Accept him today as he died on that cross, with his arms wide open, cordially inviting you in. But because he died for our sins, we can now live for him. Let's pick up our cross today and do that, shall we? Because God's not dead.
He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead. He's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion.
So beautiful to know that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Amen. So as we celebrate the rest of this Resurrection Day, this Easter Sunday, I would ask all of you that are watching today, pick up your cross and follow Jesus, because he is the way, the truth, and the life everlasting. He wants us to have our salvation in heaven. This is why he died for us, as a living sacrifice, as a love offering from God, as a sin offering for the sinner. The least we can do is live for him, offer his glory, and offer his purpose, because he always takes good care of us, and he always has, and he always will. He'll never fail. Never leave us nor forsake us. This is our Heavenly Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is unfailing in love, unconditionally loving, exceptionally. Let's live with intention. Let's live with purpose. We can do it if we choose to do it. And it's not hard. Stop saying that it is, because now you've defeated yourself and your purpose of life. Let's defeat Satan together, shall we? And we can. We just have to stand on truth and the foundation of God. Let's rise above our ashes of torment that we left behind us. Because God's not dead. He's surely alive. He is living on the inside, just roaring like a lion. So, brethren, until we meet again, be blessed and a blessing to others. And to God be edified to the highest mountain. And to God be magnified across all the earth through every nation. And to God be glorified to the highest realms of heaven. Because, brethren, we already know that Jesus has already gotten the victory over this life that we now live in, as he dwells within our hearts, living in us with his Holy Spirit. Dead bones, arise. Wake up and come out of the darkness and come into the light and sin no more. Amen? Amen.
How God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead.
He's not dead, brethren. He lives within you. Peace and blessings and one love. Amen? Amen.